New data arrived. Why do I need to copy this formula over and over again? Is there any workaround? After watching this video, you won't struggle with copying formulas to each new row anymore. This is the most comprehensive array formula tutorial you could ever expect to find on YouTube. I will present 4 practical cases and the greatest array formula hacks, so stay with me. Let's say you have a table with data and need to perform the same operation with all the cells in a given range. Instead of copy-pasting your formula to each single row, you can use the array formula, and it will distribute your operation to all of the cells. Besides saving your time and reducing manual work, array formula helps you to save your spreadsheet's capacity and power, and also works way better than 100 or even 1000 formulas would do. Let's have a look at how it works in G-Sheets. I'm going to show you the general array formula syntax using a simple mathematical expression, where I need to sum 2 values from 2 different cells. Let's say we want to sum B2 and C2, then B3 and C3, and so on. I start with a simple mathematical expression. B2 plus C2. To convert the simple formula into the array formula, we just need to add cell ranges that you want the formula to apply to and wrap the obtained expression into it. First, I convert both cell indexes into ranges. In our case, it is B2 to B5 and C2 to C5. Now, wrap it up in parents and add an array formula in the beginning. So the result will look like this. Hit enter. And the sum was distributed to all of the cells in the specified range. As simple as this. Remember that the array formula works vertically and distributes your calculation within a column. I think you understood the general logic of how array formula works. Now, let's have a look at a few real examples. And remember, if you want to jump right to a specific case, you can use the timestamps in the video description box. The case I'm going to show you now presents the greatest hack of all times related to array formula. To do it, I need to import my dataset from Airtable to Google Sheets. For this, I use coupler.io. This tool makes data import easier than the regular approach when you need to download a table as a CSV and then manually upload it to Google Sheets. In addition, I set up a schedule for automatic refreshes of the information in my worksheet to run on an hourly basis. This is how the output looks like. I will make it a bit prettier with bold headers and freezing the first row. Let's also color these. We see the number of delivered items and prices per unit. Let's calculate the total income for delivered items per product. We need to multiply the price per unit value and the number of delivered items correspondingly. What would you do in this case? If you're just like me in the past, you would write a simple multiplication formula, B2 asterisk E2 in the first row, and copy-paste it to other rows by just dragging it to the bottom of your table. To apply array formula here, the first step we do is convert single cell values into cell ranges. I will use B2 to B and E2 to E to cover all of the future data inputs that might appear. Next, place this expression into round brackets and add array formula at the beginning of it. Our array formula applied to the column until the end of the document. It happened because I stated an open range, like B2 to B, not a closed one, like B2 to B17. How can we remove these zeros while leaving our cell range open for new entries? And here comes the array formula hack. To remove these zeros, you can use a combination of if and len. Just to remind you, the if function works by performing a logical test that returns only one of two outcomes. One, if the logical test is true, and the other one, if it is false. The formula structure includes the logical test, comma, value if it is true, comma, and value if it is false. Save the link to Railsware Product Academy video about if function for later by clicking the card above. Len function returns the length of the string. My idea is expand my calculation to all of the rows where the cells with initial values are not blank. So if the length of a value in column B is more than 0, use calculation. If it is empty, leave the cell blank. How will it look like in our formula? We add if inside the array formula, open parenthesis, add a logical test, if length of B2 to B is equal to 0, comma, then if the test is true, leave the cell blank. I simply don't add any value here, just one more comma. If it is false, so the cell actually contains values, add our mathematical expression here. Don't forget to add all the needed brackets in the end. The bracket pair is highlighted in gray when you move through the formula. Make sure all the brackets have a pair. Stop for a moment and review this formula structure attentively. I would recommend you to always use it with the array formula. This way, you don't have 1,000 formulas in all of the rows, and you actually have only the needed values that you work with now. Other cells are truly blank and don't overload your file. Hit enter and all those zeros fade away. I hope this approach will be a great help in the future. If this was something you were looking for, don't forget to click like and subscribe to our channel for even more useful tips. Let's have a look at a few more examples. We can use array formula with a nested if function to check if we need to order more items. Let's use this column and write a standard if statement, which will check whether there are enough, so meaning more than 10, items left in stock for the next month. Let's add the title Order More. Here, I'd like to display the text Order if there are less than 10 items left in stock, and No if there are more than 10 items left in stock. We put an equal sign, open the brackets, write the cell reference to check, then write our condition, which is less than 10. If the logical expression is true, then the formula should return order. And if the expression is false, then no. And close the brackets. The if function performs its calculation with ease, and we can see that since there are only 8 items left in stock, the displayed text says order. Now, let's run the test for each item, and this is where a single array formula comes in handy. Type your array formula with if in the top first cell where you need to perform the calculation, and it will run the if statement across all the rows at once. To do it, just take the existing if formula into brackets, write array formula straight after the equal sign, and add one more closing bracket at the end of the expression. Then, convert the cell reference into a range, C2 to C. And use the if-len approach to remove the unneeded values. I add one more if right after the array, open parens, len of C2 to C is equal to 0. If this is true, show nothing. Otherwise, complete the logical test with the second if. Hit enter. For the array formula to work, you cannot add any values manually to the cell with the formula and its output. Not to make any mistakes, we use color coding here at Railsware. Mark the cell containing formula dark yellow and the outputs, so the whole column after in this case, in light yellow. This is how you can find the formula fast and not make any mistakes. Cool, right? By the way, array formula can also help you perform specific manipulations with texts. You can combine two pieces of text using the array formula, or a text with a number, or a text with a date, and then populate your results using the array formula to all of the rows in a given range. I will now show you how to do it. And by the way, if you want to learn even more tricks related to array formula, I've left a link to a really useful blog post in the video description. You can use it. Let's say we have a list of sales managers and need to combine their first and last names. Use the following formula. put an equal sign, then type in A2, the cell containing the first name of the sales manager, then add the ampersand sign instructing Google Sheets to connect the first and the last names in a single cell. After that, type in a space wrapped into double quotes, and in this way, we let the Google Sheets know that when connecting the first and the last name, one should account for a space between them. Add one more ampersand sign and type in B2, the cell containing the last name of a sales manager. The full name appears here. So let's use the ARRAYFORMULA function to have all the first and last names in the column coupled. To do it, just wrap this expression into ARRAYFORMULA. I place this expression into brackets and add ARRAYFORMULA at the beginning of it. Don't forget to use the if-len approach, or simply state the exact ranges A2 to A14 and B2 to B14. See? It works! Following the logic of the previous example, let's have a look at how ARRAYFORMULA can be used with the SUMIF function. Let's go back to our previous example with the product sales list. SUMIF is used to add values based on a single condition. See our video explaining how SUMIF works. Let's say you need to find out how many stationery items have already been ordered. In this column, let's call it requested category. I will specify the categories I'm interested in – stationery, instruments, and miscellaneous. Or I can use the unique formula to pull all the unique values from the categories list. This way, I will have updated information at any time. In the first cell of the ordered per category column, I write the following formula – an equal sign, SUMIF, an opening bracket, then I state the range which will be tested against our criterion, which is category in our case, then define the criterion itself, which is located in the requested category column. Later, I add information about the actual sum range, so the range that needs to be summed if the criterion is true, and in our case, it is the number ordered. Close the brackets. If you want to know the number of items already ordered for every category I listed in the column I, the best way to do it is to apply ARRAYFORMULA. In the first cell of the ordered per category column, I take the existing SUMIF formula into brackets, write ARRAYFORMULA straight after the equal sign, and add one more closing bracket at the end of the expression. I will also add if-len, but here I will test if cells in I2 to I are empty or not, as we only need values for these. Hit Enter, and don't forget to mark the formula cell and its outputs with the relevant colors. Here is one more trick we constantly use here at Railsware. In terms of the data organization, it's easier to know that all of your formulas are in a single row. That's why we often combine the header and the ARRAYFORMULA and place those in row number 1. The syntax is very simple. Copy our header text, wrap our existing expression into curly brackets, and add our header in quotes before the formula. Then, divide those with a semicolon. Move this cell to replace the initial header and correct the color coding a bit. And here it is. I will also leave a practice sheet for you in the video description. And if you plan to use any of the tricks I'm presenting here now, don't forget to click like for this video to reach even more viewers. Unfortunately, ARRAYFORMULA doesn't work with the SUMIFS function. However, there is a workaround. The combination of the ARRAYFORMULA and SUMIF can handle multiple criteria, and at the same time, it will distribute your operation to all of the cells in a given range. The main tip here is to combine the ranges and the corresponding criteria using the ampersand. Let's say we need to calculate the number of items to order soon per category. To do it, here I write the formula following everything we've learned today. Open curly brackets and add a header to order in quotes, semicolon, then type ARRAYFORMULA, open round brackets, if len is equal to 0, comma, add nothing, comma. Here comes our SUMIF. As the first parameter, I need to provide the ranges to analyze. In our case, those are category and order more. I connect those with an ampersand. After that, I need to specify both criteria. So I add requested category and order value in quotes as criteria, connecting them with an ampersand. In the end, I need to provide the range to be summed if my criteria are met, which is the number ordered. Close all the brackets and don't forget about the curly one. As you may see, this formula worked and it is perfectly expandable. Use color coding to mark where your formula is stored. So, that's it for today, and thank you very much for watching. The Google Sheets ARRAY formula is a multi-purpose tool. It can be used with many more other combinations and applications. If you have any in mind and would like to discuss them, comment below and wait for the new educational videos. Don't forget to subscribe to Railsware Product Academy channel. That's it for today, and see you next time!